गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग अ टॉपिक रिएक्शन ऑफ कायरल मॉलिक्यूल। डियर स्टूडेंट, वी नो वेरी वेल अबाउट द कायरल मॉलिक्यूल। कायरल मॉलिक्यूल इज ऑप्टिकली एक्टिव मॉलिक्यूल वेयर द कार्बन इज सब्स्टिट्यूटेड विद फोर डिफरेंट वैलेंसीज लाइक ए बी सी and D. These molecules are non-superimposable mirror image. Means if we have the left hand and right hand, if we will overlap this left hand on the right hand, then it cannot be superimposed on each other. So that is a simple example of chiral molecule. Here we have some pictorial representation where we are showing the chiral molecule. So A, B, C, D, these all are the four different substituent which are lying on the central carbon. Here we have the good example where the methyl, chloro, fluoro and hydrogen substituent are the part of this chiral carbon sheet, which will be shown here with the help of asterisk mark. So now we are considering the reaction of chiral molecule. If any molecule have the chiral center, then which type of reaction it will generally produce? So dear student, chiral molecules are generally undergo into the three type of major reaction. The first one is retention, another one is inversion, and third one is racemization. So one by one we will cover all the reactions. So the first reaction is a retention reaction, means something is going to be retained inside the molecule or overall reaction. Once the reaction will be going on, the three things are generally involved in any reaction. The first one is substrate, another one is a reactant, and it will produce the product. So S R will produce a product. So in the retention reaction, if the configuration of substrate is R, so that same configuration should be retained into the product. Dear student, we know very well about the different configuration of the molecule like D, L, R, S, plus, minus configuration. So if we are taking any R isomer of the substrate in a beginning, then the same configuration will be lying into the product. So such type of reactions are generally known as retention reaction, where the configuration of the product will be retained. We can understand that mechanism with the help of this reaction. The middle with center is a chiral carbon. That's why A, B, C and X, four different substituents are present on this carbon. Here inside the reaction, a Y group is going to react with this chiral carbon. Then again you can see a substituted product is coming on. It is coming on here where the R is generally substituted at the place of X. So you can see here in the product the Y is generally aligned at the same position from where the X will be relieved. So in this case the configuration of molecule is retained. So it is a good example of retention of configuration or retention reaction. Here we have the example. You can see here a carbon that have the different valency 1, 2, 3 and 4, that is the overall group which will be considered as a valency. So that carbon is a chiral carbon, so that's why the chiral center is mentioned over here. It is going to react with silver hydroxide in the presence of water, and you can see the bromine group will be relieved out when the hydroxyl group will approach this same position. So the hydroxyl group are substituted at the same position where in the previous substrate bromine was present. So we can say the product have the same configuration as the substrate. So again, that is a good example of retention of configuration. The another type of reaction is the inversion reaction, or we can say inversion of configuration of the reaction. So dear student, here the substrate will be totally differ with the product once we will consider their configuration. So when the molecule or the chiral molecule configuration of substrate and product is entirely changed, then the reaction will be inversion reaction. We can say the overall configuration of the product will be flip out in this case, just because of the different mechanism of reaction. So we can understand that inversion of configuration with the help of this example. Here you can see the substrate is the methyl chloride and the attacking species is hydroxyl group. So hydroxyl group is attacking towards molecule from the back side. That's why it is showing in the transition state. Once the hydroxyl group will be attacked towards the carbon, then at the same time the chlorine will be comes out in a form of chloride. So simultaneously some bond will be formed here and some bond will be break here. So such type of intermediate stage which is showing the bond formation as well as bond breaking, it is simply known as the transition state. And finally you can see the hydroxyl group is totally changed from the original molecule or substrate. In the substrate the chlorine group were present towards right side, but in case of the product which is methyl alcohol, here the hydroxyl group is present into the invert position. So finally we can say the overall configuration of the molecule is entirely changed over here. So it's a good example of inversion of configuration or inversion reaction, which is a reaction of chiral carbon. The next reaction is the racemization reaction. In the racemization reaction, a chiral molecule convert into equal proportion of both enantiomers. Means if the R isomer is participating in the reaction as a substrate, so it will be equally divided into their two halves. So you can see the RR or RS isomers are the product of this reaction or racemization reaction. Same here, the S isomer of the substrate will also divide into their equal half. So the RS isomer will form here, L and D isomer will form here, plus and minus isomer will form here into 1:1 ratio. So the both isomer will be represent into the reaction. We can understand that thing with the help of this example. Here you can see that carbon is a chiral carbon and it is going to react with lithium iodide. So the two isomers are coming here with the 50-50% of yield. Okay, so that is a first isomer and it is another isomer. If we will consider the reaction how it is possible, so we have some proposed mechanism of the reaction. You can see here, first the chloride ion is going to relieve the chiral molecule. Now we are showing the good leaving group in the reaction. Then a carbocation will be formed. Once the chloride ion will be comes out with their electron, then the carbon will show itself as a electron deficient. Then देयर इज अ न्यूक्लियोफाइल विच विल बी अटैक ऑन द कार्बन. सो देयर इज अ फिजिबिलिटी ऑफ न्यूक्लियोफाइल विच कैन अटैक फ्रॉम द बोथ साइड. इधर इट कुड बी फ्रंट साइड और इट कुड बी बैक साइड अटैक. सो यू कैन सी द टू पाथ्स आर जनरली गोइंग टू बी फॉलो विद द हेल्प ऑफ न्यूक्लियोफाइल. फर्स्ट वन इज अ ए पाथ विच इज अ बैक साइड अटैक. अनादर वन इज द बी पाथ विच इज अ फ्रंट साइड अटैक. सो इन केस ऑफ फ्रंट साइड और बैक साइड अटैक द टू इक्वल आइसोमर्स will be generate or produce at the end of reaction, which will be known as a racemic mixture. So dear student, that is whole about the reaction of chiral molecules. Hope this lecture will be beneficial to all of you. Thanks.